Hey guys, Andrew here, and welcome back to another episode of Zelda. When we last left off, we basically finished the plateau and got this nice fancy parasail. And now we just need to use the Sheikah thing, Amabob, to mark the next tower we want to go to, which is not there apparently, not at the village. Oh, there's another temple over there too. Let's see, is there anything else we can do? Doesn't look like it. Just one temple there and the tower over there. And that is still on the right area, correct? Oh no, those are definitely not in the right area. Oh boy. Oh shit. Actually, could you... There it is. Skadoosh. And... Skadoosh. And... Skadoosh. And... Skadoosh. Okay. So, I want to then convert these pins into what they are. Change to stamp. And this is the stamp of... we're just gonna put them as stars for now. Or I'll put that as a star for now. Those will be temples that I'll go to later. These are towers. These are the four towers that I need to get to. There should be a tower. That one's already marked. But what about that tower? Ahaha! And that tower's in that location? Nice! Okay. So, for now then, I'm gonna go ahead and delete these pins. Because they are kind of worthless. But I will keep that marked, so I know where a temple is. I guess I should look and see if there's any temples on my way. Doesn't seem to be any. What is that? Nope, just ruins. Okay, everything else looks pretty good. No temples around here. And I guess we'll just... And glide. That is a big looking dude. I'm just gonna go ahead and ignore that guy. So if I let go of X, will I just plummet? No. Ooh. Okay, that was scary for a second. I was like, I might die here. Alright, and landed. Okay, so Hyrule Kingdom. What's that? Wooden bow. This wooden bow may not be the most reliable for battling monsters, but it is excellent for hunting small animals. Oh, okay. Well, apparently I'm all full of bows. Ancient screw. How many bows do I have? Go ahead and whoop. And I have that one, a lot of those, and that one. So, let's get rid of the Boku bow. Oops. Yeah, let's get rid of the Boku bow. That one is Poopy Butts. Poopy Butts. Take this wooden bow, though. Could always use more hunting supplies. Let's see. Nope. That's not what I was trying to do. Got him. Okay, can I break this? No. Looked like it was rumbling, so I wanted to see if I could take it. Rusty Claymore, a two-handed sword not properly cared for, although it can be used as a weapon. Its durability is very low. Don't expect it to last for more than a few strikes. Oh, that's unfortunate. I guess I'll just continue pounding this. Ooh, got a shroom out of it. So you can break those. Okay. Oh, that broke. Okay. Can I break this upon something else? No. Okay. I'm gonna grab these fangs. I'm gonna run over here. I'm gonna grab this claymore. And then I'm just going to book it, I guess. Let's keep moving. We're in a big world, guys, all right? We're in the biggest world Nintendo has ever created. So we can come back later if need be, if we find anything that sounds fancy or ritzy that we'd like to keep. But for now, it all seems pretty mundane. Yeah, there's not really anything going around in these areas. Whoop. What about over here? Nope, nothing. Huh. I mean, it is a ruin through and through. There's just nothing left to excavate. Ooh, this entire area looks suspicious. I mean, we might as well check out the ruins, right? Might as well just check out everything, honestly. Rusty shield. It's likely this rusty old shield once belonged to a knight, but it still has some defense capabilities, but its usefulness has been worn down by time. How are my shields looking? Got a lot of... I can get rid of my Boko shield. That's not what I wanted. And yep. Okay. What was I? I really hate that I have to do this to get rid of stuff. Alright, I'll take this. Seems tolerable. Ooh, a treasure chest. Is there a problem with the treasure chest, or what's the dealio? What's this? Examine. Was this book always here? First page. Oh, Miso's EX journal. I hid the 8 priceless relics I stole from Hyrule Castle in treasure chest. I shall write down their locations. Misko. The ancient mask lies at the ruins where soldiers gathered. From there, the waters of Lake Colomo are visible. The green garments of the man who wished to be a fairy are hidden in the ruins of Hyrule Field. Find these pieces at the ruins where trade flourished. At the ruins where sinners were imprisoned. And at the village ruins next to farmland where many people once gathered. The Princess of Twilight, whose stories are handed down alongside those of the Hero of Twilight, her helmet can be found at the temple ruins soaked in the waters of Rensia River. Armor worn by fierce phantoms, feared even by heroes, is hidden in the fields of Hyrule Field. Find these pieces at a battleground where brave souls tested their skill. At ceremonial grounds where royal guards are honored. And at the ruins where the soldiers of Hyrule gathered. EX is all that's written on the last page. What could it mean? Okay. Side quest. Ancient masks. Okay. Damn it. Again, that's not what I wanted. Activate! Ah. Bagayam. Oh, my God. Open this. What you got in you? Amber. That's it? What? All you had was amber in you? Hogwash. Hogwash, I say. Hogwash! Oh. What was I trying to do? Right. Oh. It's another rusty shield. Oh, I guess this one's dead. I assumed it was alive because it didn't have legs sticking out, and that was so far the symbol that there might be bad guys around. Ruins. Map. Sure. Oh, wait, what did it say? Sheikah Slate data is damaged. Oh. Sheikah Slate data has been damaged. That's not good. So, adventure log, EX treasures. Ah. Let's see. The ancient mask lies at the ruins where soldiers gathered. From there, the waters to Lake Colomo are visible. Hidden Hyrule Field. Rensia River. Okay. So, are any of these things nearby? I don't know, because there's literally nothing on my map to signify anything. Okay, well, I'm glad I checked that area out. Found some fancy stuff. So let's check out the other buildings real quick and see if there's anything of noteworthy notiness. Doesn't look like it. Nope. Okay, these are just homes now. Okay, really wish I had a horse of some kind. A horse would be nice. A horse, of course. Oh, and yep. Yep. Nice. All right, there's a giant claymore. Both of these lead into this room with the giant claymore. Nothing else. Oh, there's a treasure chest up there. I could take the short way, but why do that when there's a long way to take? Haha. Traveler's bow. Well, I already have a lot of those, so you can stay there. Boomp. Let's see. What else we got? Oh, we already checked those buildings out. I can check this one all the way at the end over here. Oh, someone's nearby. Oh. Wait, what bow am I using? The wooden bow. No, that's... We agreed not to use that except for animals. Oh god, he is about to swipe. Time to go. Are you ready for this? Ah! Okay, that didn't work out as I planned. Okay, let's eat some food. Meat skewer sounds good. Eat that. And pump pump. Alright. You're not getting that rusty shield back, so... Oh, and you dropped your weapon. Literally no threat to nobody. And... bam. I can still cut grass. That's fancy. Bokoblin guts. Ugh. A rare material obtained by defeating a bokoblin. It convulses on its own every now and then, which is really creepy, but perhaps it has a use. Yeah, it's being really creepy. That's its fucking use. Alright, let's go up here. Why was this guy hanging out in here? Ah, a treasure chest. Ah, an arrow. But mostly a treasure chest. Probably something I already have. Oh, red rupee. 20 rupees. Its red luster tickles your heartstrings. That's a way to define those. let's see. Nope, nothing else. Alright, let's get on out of here. There's a lot of bats. Are those bats a threat? They are a threat! Oh, shit. Those bats are a scary threat. What do you do about them? Swing your sword wildly? Got him. And they're gone. Well, I guess not showing fear is what worked the best after all. And away we go. Okay, what else we got? Let's check our map real quick. And we're about to veer off track. So, this is the end of the area that I'm supposed to be in. I could go off and wander about aimlessly. Oh, there's some bokoblins over there. Ah. East Post ruins. You don't say. I didn't notice on the account that they're ruined. Okay, what do we got in there? It's a building. I don't care about that. Oh, it's one of the big guys. Oh, it's not even bokoblin. Oh, boy. Oh, okay, and I'm taking this. No weapon for you, dude! Ah! That was worth it. Moblin horn. This splendid horn once grew atop the head of a moblin. It can't be used in normal food recipes, but it does have some use as an ingredient in making elixirs. And moblin fang. A sharp fang obtained from a moblin. It's too hard to be reshaped into a tool, but it can be tossed into a stew with some critters to create elixirs. Huh. It's another rusty shield. Got some chew jelly. Oh, you're awake. Interesting. And strain the head. Got him. Oh, shit. Take that. Thank you for your generous contribution to society. Dumbass popper. Oh. Oh, you hit for one. Got him. I like stealing their weapons and using them against them. It's kind of funny, actually. It's like funny in an insulting way. As if like, yeah, take that. Thanks for the weapon. Right in your asshole. Oh, shit. Nice. Nailed it. Oh. Man, those guys are not as threatening as I once believed that they were going to be. Oh, those are some birds. Yeah. Ah, worth it. I got one piece. Oh, thought there was a lizard on the wall. I was like, ooh, more meat. I'll take the raw bird drumstick. Seems like a good idea. All right, what else we got? Oh, it's a moblin. Hey, buddy, what you got there? Oh, there's a lot of you. Okay, I was not expecting that. It's a little too many for my taste, personally. Hip. Okay. Go ahead and eat a seared steak. Got a lot of those. You're the real threat. Okay, so I need to bust out a new weapon. I'm thinking... Boko Cloak. What is that you just dropped? That's what I'm concerned about. Oh, shit. That is a long-reaching weapon. Okay. I'll take this. A wooden mop. Just a mop to the untrained eye. It excels at tidying up the place, but it owes its sturdy construction to a true craftsman, so it actually has some combat merit. Wow. What is the, Nope, nope, nope. Taking this off. Got him. What is the, what's it called? What's the, like, the jump button? That's what I want to know. What is this? Farming hoe. A farming tool primarily used for tilling fields. Its fine craftsmanship is sturdy enough to withstand back-breaking field work, but its battle applications are untested. Well, I'm glad someone decided to test them. What is... What? Search. Amber. Okay. I guess I was just on the cart itself, or... I don't know. In any case, let's keep moving. We made some negative progress. We walked backwards. Let's see. This village. Sounds good. Sounds good. All right. Looking good. Ooh. Is that a temple I see? Well, fuck me. There's a temple right there. Oh. And apparently rocks. Can I... Ah, flint. Yes, so I can use this hammer to break apart rocks. Nice. Nice. Rock salt. Crystallized salt from the ancient sea, commonly used to season meals, cannot be eaten in this form. Good to know. All right, so let's see. Well, there's a temple here, so let's go ahead and use the temple. I mean, who knows? There might be some cool, fancy stuff hidden in this temple. I don't know. I don't even know how temples work now that I have all the abilities. Do I just gain a bunch of abilities every time I go to a temple, or do I have to just use my common wits with the current abilities that I have to beat all the remaining temples? I guess we'll find out. All right. Interesting. Oh. To you who sets foot in this shrine, I am Bosh Kala. In the name of the goddess Hylia, I offer this trial. Okay, thanks, dude. The wind guides you. Oh. Okay. Got it. What you got in you? Amber. Okay, I'll take that. I'm starting to get to a civilization now, so I'm assuming that there'll be something useful. Okay, I can fly back this way, but why would I ever? And whoosh. Cannot climb that. Okay, thought that was climbable. It looked very climbable. Is there something all the way over there, or what am I missing? Yeah, what am I missing here? Why does this area exist? Seems oddly suspicious. Ooh. Ah, that's why it exists, because I can jump over there and get a chest at the end. Or not at the end, because if I touch the person, then I get kicked out of the shrine. So I'd have to redo this all over again. So, yep. Fly me. No, shit. My bad. I fucked up. What happens when you fuck up in a shrine? Oh, okay, you just lose some hearts and come back. I didn't know how to stop. Because I'm not accustomed to that. I actually don't find myself needing to stop often. I want to go over there, but I'm afraid it's going to be a weapon, and then I'm going to feel like I wasted my time. Oh well, no time like the present. Shit. Well, that is suckaroonies. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and eat real quick, since apparently I have really fucked up here. Steamed meat, skewer, baked apple, yeah. I'm gonna eat some of these baked stuff. Because I have a lot of these, and I feel like I'm gonna start cooking more than I am gonna be needing quick, tiny heals. Alright, what's up, dude? You're just gonna give me a soul thing? Is that what you're gonna do? I'm assuming he's just gonna give me a soul thing. Yep. Spirit Orb. This guy's also not meditating. He's just hanging out. Alright, dude. See ya. Well, I did a shrine. Cool. Now I have 5 Spirit Orbs. Whatever that means. I have no idea what these Spirit Orbs are for. I'm assuming they're for something useful. God, I hope they're for something useful. I'd be really upset if they're just worthless. I'm assuming you use them for... What could you use them for in this game? Does this game have level up system? Does it have, like, a system for leveling up and gaining more abilities or something? Or, I don't even know. That's the thing. Like, what is the purpose of this? Are you gonna tell me about teleportation rooms? What the fuck? Wait, what? Also. Oh, shit. A fox. Hip! Got him. Oh, shit. Got him. There we go. Fox meat. Raw meat. Okay, in any case, what was I saying? Adventure log. Teleportation rumors. Rumor has it there's a tool that allows you to instantly travel wherever you place it. Apparently, South Akala Stable has a copy of Super Rumor Mill EX, which details some rumors about this rare item. The ancient mask lies at the ruins where soldiers gathered. From there, the waters of Lake Colomo are visible. Okay. Oh, mask rumors. Rumor has it there's an item called the Koroko mask that has the power to alert its wearer when a Koroko is hiding nearby. Apparently, the Woodland Stable has a copy of Super Rumor Mill EX, which details some rumors about the rare mask. This is all DLC content, it seems. Which has no bearing on what I'm currently doing. So, if I go straight, I'll get to the pin, which is the tower, right? Is that what I put? Yep, there's the tower. And away we go! Okay. What the hell is that? Sounds like something jumped in. Oh, nope, people are throwing stuff at me. And about to drown. Okay, so I need to really find a way to get more stamina. Also, who is throwing stuff at me? Ah! Oh, you guys have come back. Great. Nope, that's 10 out of 10 right there. Okay, well, I'm gonna have to cross the bridge since apparently I am not allowed... Oh, I'll take that. Since I am not allowed to swim across. Because I am too weak. And feeble. And both weakly feeble. Oh, hey. I'll take the Stamella Shroom, which can regain some stamina. Oh, these guys have a treasure chest that I might want to procure. Oh, and they have a cooking thing. Good, because I have some stuff to cook. So I'm going to go ahead over here. What is that? Throwing spear. A specialized spear, weighted to excel at throwing as a throwing weapon. It's perfectly balanced to be thrown farther than your average spear, able to pierce targets from a great distance. Apparently I'm all out of... Oops. I am all out of items to carry. Ah, because of my thing. Fucking farming hoe. Yep. That didn't work. Oh, shit. It's not what I wanted to do. No. Okay. Ah, there we go. Yep. Whoa. Well, everyone died. That was actually worth it. Just for the. Oh my God, he's on fire. Oh, I don't have a weapon. Bust out that rusty sword. Got him. Wow, that was a good idea, Andrew. Good idea. You damn blewed up that place. I'll take that. All your weapons are on fire. Don't give a shit. I'll take that. I'll take that. I'll also take these and this and this. And anything else you guys want to generously donate? To the Poor Link College Fund. Okay, what do we got here? Please be soldier's bow. Nice. Inventory is full, though. Is it now? Because last I checked, it certainly was pretty empty in my book. Hint, hint. Get out. All right. And bam, soldier's bow. Nice. Okay. So, we have that taken care of. I'm going to grab this horn. How many weapons we got? We still got full-on weapons. That's good. Now we are over in the next territory, so that's not as good. We kind of diverted from the path. But we now have a cooking apparatus. So, let's get cooking! Let's see. I'm going to take... hold, hold, and hold. And you know what? Add one more piece to that. No, wait, I should save that. I shouldn't be so hasty on throwing all my shit into one thing. Yeah, let's make minor meals. Minor meals are probably a good idea. Energizing salt grilled meat. Instantly refills some of your stamina wheel. Short on ingredients, just rub some meat in, salt and cook it for a simple tasty dish. Ah, I wasn't short on ingredients, that's why I put three things in there. But, good to know that I can put some, apparently salt grilled meat is 3 hearts, which is exactly how many hearts I have. How many salts do I have? Only one. Okay, this healthy herb grows. Ah, cook it before eating to increase the number of hearts it restores. Hold. 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 Yes. Let's throw that into a pot and see what that makes us. Steamed mushrooms. A healthy vegetable dish achieved by steaming mushrooms and plant leaves. It's not really that interesting. Let's see. Can we make something more interesting? What if we took you and you and you and you? And you and shit. Yeah, whatever. That's fine. Throw it in there. Let's see what we got. Steamed meat. 5 hearts. This meat dish has been wrapped in fragrant leaves and steamed to preserve its moisture. All right. So now that we have that out of the way, I'm gonna go ahead and grab. Oh right, I forgot to cook the base. Cook the base. Hold. Take 2 of those and a Stamina shroom. Throw it in there. What we got? Energizing fish and mushroom skewer. Wow, that's a lot of hearts. Okay. Let's go ahead and take hold one of these and one of these. Throw that in there. That should be fish and mushroom skewer. Just three hearts. Perfect. All right. And then go ahead and hold one of these and one of these. And one of these two, just in case. Oop. Spicy simmered fruit. Nice. All right. And I think that's about, yeah. So go ahead and give me one of these. In making elixirs. That's the hard part. I'm going to take a Moblin Tooth and a Bokoblin Fang and a Frog and see what we make with this. Hasty Elixir. Grants a low-level haste effect, which boosts your movement speed while running, swimming, or climbing. Is that better than the other ones that I have? Yes, by a lot. By a whole 2 minutes. Okay, so I have one more frog. Hold, grab, horn. Throw into a pot. What we got? Hasty elixir for 11 minutes. Holy shit. Well then, that's handy. That's actually really handy, all things considered. So I can combine those with, what's it called? With food items and also make it give me health when I do that. Run. Let's see exactly how good this haste elixir is. All right. Hey there, dude. I may be somewhat used to seeing bad omens by now, but that, well, it's, let's just say it's badder than most. Mm-hmm. We're doomed. I mean, don't panic. Sorry, who are you? Have we met? Well, it doesn't matter who you are, really. I was getting tired of talking to myself, so you've come at a good time. By the way, those strange things that popped out of the ground, did you see them? I'm not talking about mushrooms here. I'm talking about those towers. They seem to have popped up all over the place. And that's not the only strange thing that's happened. Those long, deserted shrines suddenly started glowing. You know what this means, don't you? The end is here. With all this craziness happening, I've been keeping an eye on that thing. Just to see if it suddenly starts moving, you know? What thing? I'm talking about that guardian, of course. Haven't you heard the old stories about Hyrule? See that thing over there? The one that's shaped like an overturned urn? That is what I'm talking about. Did you know some of them can move? One of them once chased me down and tried to kill me. This one here? No, it was a different one. That one closer to the castle, but before the forest. When they spot you, they shoot blue beams of light at you. Man, I was so sure that was the end for me. I was prepared for the worst. But I somehow managed to escape into the nearby woods. You think it was my lightning-fast reflexes that saved me? Huh, I wish. Truth is, I just got lucky. Anyway, I hear guardians like that still wander around Hyrule Castle. Be careful. Hey, don't be rash. You won't change the world by jumping carelessly to your doom, don't you know? That would only do one thing, and that's drive me batty. Seriously, think of the shock I'd suffer, seeing something like that. You're fine, just don't be so careless. There are too many enjoyable things in the world to gamble with your life. Wow, I mean, your anti-suicide speech has taught me well. I will not do that ever again. Sorry about that. Hey, what's up there, buddy? Ancient screw. Oh, there's a thing. There's a chest in the thing. Oh, God! What? It's mine! What is this? Sneaky river snail. This large glow-in-the-dark snail lives in fresh water. When cooked into a dish, it heightens your senses so you can move about silently. Oh, we're gonna have a bouncing party. Okay. Well, it's good to know that, oh, God. God, you guys have good reach. Let's see here. And debt. And critical headshot. Critical headshot. Oh, just one shot was enough. Okay, never mind. Wasted some arrows. Robber drumstick. Ah, yes, some more fresh meat. I like when you miss arrows, you can pick them back up. That's handy. Keeps it so I always have a never-ending supply of arrows. Oh, good, some more enemies for me to kill in probably a hilariously awesome fashion way. Pay no mind to the boy in green. All right, take this shroom. Let's see, you probably had a bundle of arrows on you, didn't you? Please tell me you had a bundle of arrows. Thank you. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and sneak up on these guys using my magnet powers. And shabam! Shabam! Ha! That's fun. Oh yeah? Well, fuck off. Ah! Right, I only had one heart. Right! I really need to find the roll button. I really need that button. Not having a roll button's really tough. And I'm really hoping my last save wasn't too far. Hoping it was right before I entered this area, so I still have those animal carcasses on my body. Those would be great. Great! Thank you. Thank you very much. Ah, alright. So, I don't have much of my speed left. So, run. Don't mind the boy in green. Shh. Right in the face. Okay. Alright, I'm gonna go grab this stuff. He did not drop arrows this time. That makes me sad. That's okay. There we go, and no. Oh, and no. And no. Nice. Nailed it. You can break these, apparently. And they guess they give you rupees or something. I don't know. Take the bokoblin guts, though. Yeah, because there's some rupees over here. Green rupee. A single rupee. Its soft green glow puts a smile on your face. What's that? Roasted bass. Bass has been cooked whole over an open flame. It's flaky and savory smelling. Offers more hearts than the raw version. Great. Glad they were cooking some fish over here. Oh, yeah, I'll take your meat, too. Thank you for the seared steak. And thank you for this. And I'm gonna go ahead and climb up here. Go take whatever this is. Oh, there's some bass in the water. Opal. Nice. Oh, my speed thing's almost out. Yep. Nope, that one's gone. All right, swim out there, grab it. Mighty carp. This freshwater fish lives alongside its less mighty carp ilk. A compound in its liver promotes muscle growth. Dishes cooked with it will temporarily increase your attack power. What? Mighty carp. Yeah, I'm gonna need that, buddy. Because that sounds awesome. Okay. Now that's been taken care of, I'm gonna go ahead and keep moving forward. Wow, that area looks suspicious. Tower's all the way over there. There's another thing up there. Ah, this is getting tough. I'm running out of arrows. I need a lot of arrows. Arrows are just so nice to use. Alright, well, this place looks nice. Oh, hey. Nope. Take this. This. Hey there. Oh, God, it's a rock. Please don't drop any more rocks. Okay. It's up here. How long is this going to go on for?
Yaha! You found me!
Well, thank you.
Bye-bye!
Alright. Those things are funny. I don't know. They kind of like a weird... Their existence is weird. Check my map. Whamp. Oh, the village is still all the way over there. But the tower's right there. So, we're gonna head to the tower. Yes. Why is there a fire over here? Has somebody been firing stuff without my knowledge? Uh-oh, do I have to swim over to it? That might be a tough one if I have to swim to the tower. That might suck. Well, let's go see what's going on over here. So the fire's over yonder. Is there people there, or is it bad guys? Oh. And boom. Take the flint. And boom. Take the rock salt. Yes, rock salt. Let's see. Who is over there? Oh. Don't have any arrows. Go ahead and switch over to Rusty Sword just in case. Ha! Hightail Lizard. A lizard found throughout Hyrule. It's a bit slow to react at times, but if given a chance to escape, it will dart off quickly. Cook it with monster parts for a speed-boosting elixir. For a speed-boosting elixir? Huh. Tree branch. Oh, I don't want that. No, I don't want that. No, I don't want that. Take that tree. Huh. Hey.
Yeah.
Hey, you a traveler? Grab a spot by the fire if you like. I'm a traveling merchant. Name's Gyro. Nice to meet you. Crazy times we live in, eh? I go into the forest all on my own to get my wares.
Oh.
But there are far safer ways to get them, such as buying from travelers like you. So, do you happen to have anything rare you'd be interested in selling me?
Wanna sell?
Great, let's see what you got.
Let's see. I have this t-shirt, if you want it. It's 15 rupees. Yes. I'll buy just about anything. Is that what you just said to me? Let's see. Sort inventory. Yes? Sorted material inventory? Okay. I don't know what that means. I guess by food and then stuff that's useful. Wow, he will sell me a lot. Precious red gem mined from large ore deposits. Rubies containing the power of fire and have fetched a high price since ancient times. I don't know what these are for, though. Do I need these for crafting material? Yeah, value as a component in decorations and crafting. I don't know. Let's see. Do I have anything that's actually worth selling? I have these fucking ancient parts. I don't know if those are worth anything. I have a bunch of... Yeah, I didn't figure those were worth it. Oh, eyeballs are worth something. Apparently the shafts are pretty hard to come by. I have a bunch of food. A lot of fucking good food. Let's see here. What about the slimes? Nope. Chew jelly is not worth it. Wow. Bokoblin guts are pretty good. I don't know if I need anything, though.
Now it's my turn. Want to buy something?
Show me the goods.
Ooh. I'm proud of my wares. All of them. Please take a look.
You have that hefty truffle. This rare mushroom has a rich scent. Cook it before eating to temporarily increase your maximum hearts. What? That's impressive. Swift carrot. Okay. That truffle sounds really good, though. Increase maximum hearts. But I want the arrows.
How many are we talking?
20, 40, 60. Yep, I'll take them all.
All of them? That'll be 60 rupees. Is that okay?
Yep.
Thanks so much.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, got it. Thanks for spending some of your precious time on the road with me. Even the areas near civilization are full of monsters these days. Just strolling through the woods can be dangerous. You be careful, you hear?
To you, sir. To you. You need to be careful. I'm perfectly good. That is a long hike up. Well, let's see if I can get up there. Maybe. I don't know. I might not make it. I might have to jump off and see if I can jump from the mountain and reach it, and then just kind of get to a higher positioning. Yeah, I don't know if I'll make it. What's up here, though? What could possibly be up here that's actually worth climbing a tower this high for? Okay. Yep. Alright. Stamina, come back to me! Stamina, come back to me! Alright, so I'm gonna try jumping at it. Is there a treasure chest up there? There is a treasure chest up there. But is it a good treasure chest? Open it up. Hey! Here's a chicken wing. Nice. Much smarter of an idea. Alright, let's hoist ourselves up there. Hump. And hump. Nailed it. What you got? Please be something good. Silver rupee? 100 rupees. Its dazzling silver light reflects your beaming smile. Oh, yeah. My smile is definitely a beaming. Oh, there's some tribal people over there doing tribal things. Huh. Well, you know what? Now that we've reached the top of this... Ooh. Yeah, it's so close. I'm gonna get it so I can get this map. I'm gonna go ahead and say thank you guys for watching. If you liked what you see, go ahead and click subscribe. Otherwise, leave a comment in the comment section below. Tell me the worst Zelda player you've ever seen before. As always, thank you guys for watching. See you guys next time, and...